Hey Scorpio Collective, what's up? Welcome to the channel. Welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me. I do appreciate you all. All right, Scorpio Collective, take from this what resonates, leave what doesn't, flip the roles if you need to. Could be past, present, or future energy with someone else around you. I am picking up on. I'm trying to think here. How do I want to say this, Scorpio? What I heard as soon as I hit the record button for you was you are looking at a situation the wrong way. Something that you think is a negative is actually a blessing in disguise. Feels like an ending, feels like some type of heavy energy that you could be carrying right now, where you don't necessarily see how there could be light at the end of the tunnel, or this could be a positive, but it is. There's something ending, something that did not work out, and spirit is wanting you to know that it's divinely orchestrated to be that way. What is that saying? Rejection is God's protection, right? There's something that's not working out and you're not understanding why it's not working out. Spirit is saying, because I don't want that for you. I have something better for you, Scorpio, is what I'm hearing. Now, this could be in your career. This could be in your relationship, romantic relationship, friendship, family. It could be whatever. I see a lot going on here, but I want you to know that you are supported. Not only are you supported, you know, in the 3D, but you're also supported by your guides, your angels, your ancestors, spirit, okay? Let's get into it. We start off with your card being celebrate. Some of you could be on the Libra Scorpio cusp, and I say that because they had a card that said dance or something like that, and it was very, it had a very joyous, celebratory feeling for me. Scorpio, maybe your birthday will be significant. Something could be happening for you around the time of some kind of celebration. You could be celebrating a big win, a victory, I just heard. You're being asked to celebrate a recent accomplishment, no matter how big or small. Do something special to commemorate the moment. You deserve that and so much more. So what moment recently have you experienced? Some kind of accomplishment, some type of success, right? No matter the magnitude of it, that maybe you didn't take the time to celebrate. This could just be your birthday. This could be someone else around you's birthday. This could be a holiday. It could be anything. Maybe you set something out, a party or something here that you were supposed to attend. You were planning to attend, but maybe something fell through. Yeah, I don't know. But right now, Spirit is wanting you to take inventory of your accomplishments. Pat yourself on the back and let yourself know you're doing a good job, okay? We have opportunities coming in for you. This card says a stranger is about to change your life. Exciting times and plenty of action, plus a special family reunion looks likely. Wow. That is so interesting. Some of you can have a really tumultuous relationship with the women in your family, maybe your mother or a maternal figure, an aunt, a grandmother, a sister, older sister, whatever. There could be an opportunity for you to mend that relationship, because look, we have Mother Earth here. Feel loved and comforted. And then we also have women supporting women. So we have the number 22 here. Okay, this card says, together we can transcend our individual limitations. So you two are stronger together than you are apart. This could be a situation that fell apart that's coming back together. Others of you, it could be friendships here. This card says, I understand that a friend is in my life for a reason. It could be that some of you are, you know, ending some of your friendships and maybe making new friendships or mending old relationships with family and friends, okay? Yeah, there's some kind of breach here. We have will, and this card says breach. I feel like there's something here that did not go the way you thought it should go. We have failure. What is that number? 17. This is Tower. Now, the Tower is actually number 16 in the major arcana of the traditional tarot, but this card is number 17. Some of you can have a 16 or 17-year-old child. This could be a friendship of 16 or 17 years, a relationship of 16 or 17 years. Something about those numbers could be significant for you. Something has fallen apart here. Something suddenly ended. Someone could have had a car accident here. This person is in this little car, and it's like he hit this little child here with the car that he's in. Yeah, somebody could have had an accident recently. But I feel like this breach coming through with this failure, it's like something, a breach is when people have access to something they're not supposed to have access to, right? Confidential information gets breached. My nose started itching, y'all. So something got breached. confidential information gets breached, things that you should need a clearance for, things that only certain people should be privy to. Yeah. I feel like some kind of sudden change has happened, a sudden ending. Okay. But we have this card here, guided steps to love, follow the path of ascension. So some of you are elevating, upgrading, going through an awakening and ascension of your soul. I feel a lot of coming together with the women around you in particular. Okay. We also have breathe here. I almost neglected this card. Archangel Raphael, take several deep breaths and exhale slowly to awaken your energy and release old patterns. Yeah, there's a lot of healing coming in. Friendships, relationships, and family dynamic. There's a lot of growth taking place, a lot of ascending. Let's get some tarot. Whatever you need to know right now. Look at this healing. Six of Swords, Aquarius energy. Moving forward. This is your spirit guides being right there with you. Moving you forward to calmer waters, moving you forward to a positive change. You're leaving the baggage in the past. You're leaving the negativity behind. You're moving towards your happiness and your healing. Some of you could be going on a vacation soon, or you could be traveling for work, or maybe thinking about even moving abroad for some kind of opportunity. Major blessings coming in. Aquarius energy. Oh, wow. The sun. Get the happiest outcome here. All is going according to plan. I told y'all that at the very beginning. Spirit is saying, whatever is not working is because I don't want that for you. I have something better for you. This is a card of healing and truth. Okay? You could be healing a relationship with a child as well. Maybe you are the parent in a situation. I feel love is just kind of like radiating in your life right now. A lot of healing energy. You could also be healing health-wise, overcoming something in your health. Five of Swords. Oh, it's an Aquarius for some of you that you could have fallen out with. I feel like somebody did something real shiesty. This could be violence, abuse, betrayal. Someone selfish, someone really that sabotaged the connection with you. I feel like this person's actions backfired. They feel like they made a mistake. There's someone here, possibly an Aquarius, who wants to heal with you, possibly a Leo. For some of you, it doesn't have to be those signs. Somebody betrayed you. This is the person who did not consider your feelings. The Five of Swords is cutthroat. He's petty. He's jealous. He's vindictive. He's retaliatory. All right? This is a person who will step on anyone to get where they need to go or where they want to go. They don't have any regard for who they hurt in the process, okay? This could be a friendship. This could be a relationship. This could be a family member. King of Pentacles. Some of you could be a father figure. Divine masculine energy. King of Pentacles, again, is a father figure. It represents a patriarch. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. This could just be someone you were dealing with who could be a little bit older than you, 40 years and up. Could be someone who owns a business, very well off. But this is someone who would want a stable relationship. So either you had a stable relationship with them, you thought you did, or this is someone who's looking at you thinking, that's what I want to give you now. There could be an opportunity for you to come back together with someone where things fell apart. They could have just been a person that gave you the silent treatment. This person is very petty in the past, is what I'm hearing. May 19th, May 6th, June 5th, June 19th. 5 to 6 weeks could be significant. Some of you over the next 19 days, you could be getting some news before the summer is out. You could be hearing from this person wanting to maybe apologize to you and make things right. Show me the Six of Swords. What's the Six of Swords? Six of Cups. Could be a Scorpio. Somebody's feeling very nostalgic over you. You have a lot of good memories with this person. If you don't, they are ready to create good memories with you. You have two sixes here. June 6th could be significant. This could be playing out over the next 6 months or the past 6 months. Something is relevant about the past 6 months between you and this person. Six of Cups is essentially a feeling of nostalgia. What's the word I'm looking for? I don't know why I can't think of words sometimes. What's the word I'm looking for? Nostalgia, you know, good memories. It's like, you know, missing someone. Like I said, you have a lot of good memories with them. You're recalling those memories. You know, you're reliving those memories. Or you're thinking, I would love to create more memories, better memories with this person. You know, the sixes in tarot are all about harmonizing. They're a card of balance. They're a card of a positive change, leaving the fives, which are conflict. So yeah, there's somebody you were in conflict here with that wants to move to calmer waters with you. They want to heal. Okay. I still haven't thought of the word I'm looking for with the Six of Cups. I don't know why I can't think of it. Just forget it. Anyway, why do we have the Sun? What's the Sun? The Sun is the Knight of Swords. Okay. There's someone coming in to communicate with you really quickly. Very honest communication. Could be quite uncomfortable. This is a very blunt person. I think this person is naturally argumentative, y'all. They like to debate. Libra, Aquarius, or Gemini. Could be 20 to 35 years old. Don't have to be. But yeah, this is the person who I feel like they want to come in and shed light on maybe why they did something. Knight of Swords can make decisions that don't consider your feelings as well. They don't care about consequences. They're hasty. You know, they kind of jump out there and just do what they do and they just hope for the best. And if the best doesn't happen, oh, well, shoulder shrugs, you know, like nobody cares. Yeah, that's kind of the energy of the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is a very fast-paced energy, third fastest card in the tarot deck, in fact. So I feel like this person is wanting to come in and communicate with you, hoping for a happy ending with this Sun. Whatever happens is meant to happen, though, because the Sun is all about everything going according to plan. All is well. This is a positive outcome. The most positive outcome is here for you. This person is in love with you, and I feel like they're ready to tell you that. Show me this Five of Swords. What happened with this Five of Swords? Thank you, Spirit. Knight of Cups. Person could have been fickle, could have broken promises to you, could have had a habit of maybe overextending themselves and not being able to live up to it. Knight of Cups is a sweet person. They wear their heart on their sleeve, but they're like kind of flighty, you know? They're very much What is the saying? I know rose colored glasses is a saying, but also there's another saying. I can't think of it. I don't know why I can't think of sayings. Anyway, but the Knight of Cups wears his heart on his sleeve and he does wear rose colored glasses. Okay. A very idealistic, almost fantasy land kind of energy. Okay. So this is a person who could easily get their feelings hurt. Looks like with this Five of Swords coming out. I think a lot of you, put a lot of faith in this person and they weren't able to live up to it for whatever reason. They let you down. They sabotaged the connection. Yeah. Some of you, they were emotionally abusive here. We have the Queen of Cups. This person is in love with you. I just said it with the Queen, the King of Swords and the Ten of Pentacles. So they want to get back together with you for something serious. You got the King and the Ten of Pentacles, which means this person wants to create empire with you. Both of those cards are about empire building. King of Swords is very serious about his companion. He's loyal. He's fair. Honest. All of those things are here. Could be a Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. I think just about all the signs are here. I see Leo. I didn't see Aries and Sagittarius. Those are the only two signs I'm not seeing. But I feel like right now you're leaning on the support of your family, your friends. If not, relationships will start to mend and you will have that support system. There's something to celebrate. There's something victorious coming in here. I do feel like this person from your past wants to come back and heal this connection. And we are going to leave your reading right there. I think I have said all that I needed to say. Like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell. And I will see you all. And I see you all. Peace.